Hello students, welcome to Basic Electrical Engineering lectures. In the last class we have seen two wattmeter method of measurement of three phase power, and also we have seen an example on three phase circuit with star connected impedances to calculate the current and power. Okay, so today we'll continue the examples on three phase circuits. So I told that I had given a self-learning example for you. The same impedances, those were connected in star in the previous example. It is 2 ohm and 5 ohm impedance connected across 440 volts. Okay. We were asked to calculate the current, power and power factor. Okay. So current, line current was equals to 47.16 amperes at an angle at an angle 68.2 amperes, and P was equals to 13.33 kilowatts. Okay. I told that if the same numerical is solved with delta connection, now the homework given was delta connected network. Volts, 2 ohm, 5 ohm, 2 ohm, 5 ohm, 2 ohm and 5 ohm. So I told the power consumed in delta network will be more. Okay. So this will come out to be, I will write directly the answer, you can solve on your own. So IL is equals to here 141.56 at an angle minus 68.2, here also same minus. And power consumed is 40 kilowatts, nearly 40 kilowatts. So power consumed in delta arm is more than power consumed in star. But we have seen in the analytical derivations that the power consumed in star or delta will remain same. Okay, but now why the power consumed in delta is more? Why? Because see, 440 volt here is the line voltage and phase voltage here is 440 divided by root 3, that is 254 volts. But whereas now across 2 plus j 5 ohms the voltage is 254 volts, but whereas across 2 plus j 5 ohms the voltage is 440 volts. Okay, so blindly I cannot say that the same impedance when connected in star, whatever the power consumed I get the same power consumed in delta across the same supply. The supply should be equivalently taken. So here, if I take the in delta connection, supply to be equals to 254 volts, then I get power consumed same. I want to get a different power consumed. Okay. So here, the power consumed is more because the impedance is across 440 volts. The phase voltage is 440 volts here, whereas in first case, the phase voltage is 254 volts. This is the reason why the power consumed in delta connected across 440 volts will be more than the power consumed in star connection. Okay. So this is the justification. Now we'll move to further examples. See, I have forwarded the examples. Okay. To you, there were four examples to be solved in the class. Please go through the statements. I will read out the statement. Okay. Example number one. When three phase balanced impedances are connected in star, when three phase balanced impedances are connected in star across a three phase 415 volts 50 hertz supply,
across 3-phase 415-volt 50-hertz supply, the line current drawn is 30 amperes. The line current drawn is 30 amperes at a power factor of 0.62 lagging. Okay, at a power factor of 0.62 lagging. Determine the components of impedance in each phase. Okay, so the given statement is, there is a three-phase balanced impedances connected in star fashion. Okay, so first I will take three-phase impedances in star fashion. So three-phase impedances in star fashion, ZPH, ZPH, ZPH. Okay. So the voltage across which the load is connected is 450 volts, 50 hertz. 450 volts, 50 hertz. And the line current drawn is 30 amperes. The line current drawn is 30 amperes at a power factor of 0.62 lagging. So cos phi is equals to 0.62 lagging. Okay. Now I need to determine what are the components of impedance. Now whether it is an RL impedance or RC impedance. Okay, because power factor is less than 1 and greater than 0, so either it will be RL or it will be RC. Okay, so here it is mentioned that power factor is 0.62 lagging. When power factor is lagging, that is inductive load. Okay, or the circuit is inductive, or the impedance components are R and L. So it is evident. Okay, you can write, since power factor is lagging, since power factor is lagging, impedance components are R and L. So here I will get resistance and inductance. Okay. Therefore, I can write ZPH is equals to EPH divided by IPH. Okay, so here EPH is equals to EL by root 3, that is 415 by root 3 comes out to be 239.6 volts. Okay, and IPH equals to IL. So this is magnitude of ZPH equal to magnitude of EPH by magnitude of IPH. Okay. Therefore, ZPH equals to ZPH equals to 239.6 divided by 30. Okay, so that will come out as 7.986 ohms. Okay, we can write cos phi is equals to RPH by ZPH, and this is equals to given as 0.62. Therefore, RPH is equals to 0.62 into ZPH, that is 0.62 into 7.986. Okay. Therefore, RPH is equals to 4.95 ohms. 4.95 ohms. Now I know R, I know Z. We have ZPH is equals to under root R square plus XL square. Therefore, XL is equals to under root or RPH square XLPH square. XLPH equals to under root ZPH square minus RPH square. So this will come out as under root ZPH is 7.986 square minus 4.95 square. This will be XLPH 6.26 ohms. XLPH is 6.26 ohms. Okay. And this is equals to 2 pi f into L. Okay. Therefore, L is equals to 6.26 divided by 2 pi f. That will come out approximately 20 millihenries. 20 millihenries. So, here RPH is 4.95 ohms. And LPH is 20 millihenries in each phase. Okay. 20 millihenries in each phase. So this is the solution of first numerical or first example. So we'll move to second example. We'll move to second example. So second example states that a three-phase motor draws a power of 50 kilowatts at 0.71 power factor lagging. Okay. A three-phase motor draws a power of 50 kilowatts at 0.71 power factor lagging. What is the reading of each wattmeter when two wattmeters are connected to measure the power? Okay. Also find the reading of each wattmeter for the same power consumed for power factor 0.4 lagging and power factor 0.5 lagging. Okay. So as per the statement given in this example, I have a three phase motor connected to three-phase supply and I am using two wattmeter method to measure three-phase power drawn by this motor. Okay. So this is M, L, C, V, M, L, C, V. So wattmeter 1, wattmeter 2. Okay. So two wattmeters are used to measure the power consumed by this three phase motor. And power consumed by this three phase motor is given by 50 kilowatts. P is equals to 50 kilowatts. Now I should find the values of W1 and W2. Okay. Find W1 and W2
for first power factor equals to 0.71 lakh. Obviously, lag.
Three phase motors are lagging loads.
Okay. Second case, when power factor is equals to 0.4 lag. And third case, power factor equals to 0.5 lag.
Okay. So with three power factors, I should be finding what is the power, what is the wattmeter readings of W1 and W2 when the total power consumed is 50 kilowatts with all the three cases of power factors.
So first we'll take case 1, when power factor is equals to 0.71 and P is 50 kilowatts. Okay. So P is equals to, I have three phase power, root 3 EL IL cos phi.
Okay, P is equals to root 3 EL IL cos phi is the power consumed in three phase system. Okay, which is also equals to W1 plus W2. If I measure three phase power using two wattmeter method, the power consumed is given by the sum of two wattmeter readings. So therefore, W1 plus W2 is power consumed, and W1 plus W2 is nothing but my 50 kilowatt. Okay, which is equals to 50 kilowatt. Therefore, W1 plus W2 is equals to 50K. Now, power factor is given 0.71. So cos phi equation I have, cos phi is equals to cos of tan inverse of root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. So I know cos phi, I know W1 plus W2. If I find W1 minus W2, I will be having two equations, W1 plus W2 equal to 50K, W1 minus W2 equal to some value. If I solve those two equations, I will get W1 and W2. So this is how I have to get the solution. Now from this expression of power factor, I want to get what is W1 minus W2. So this is equals to 0.71 equals to cos of tan inverse root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. Okay. Now take cos inverse of 0.71. So cos inverse of 0.71. So cos inverse of 0.71, 44.76 is equals to tan inverse of root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. Okay. So if I take tan inverse on LHS, it becomes tan. So tan of 44.76, that will be 0.991. tan of 44.76 is 0.991 equals to, tan has gone, it will be root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. Okay. Therefore W1 minus W2 is equals to 0.991 W1 plus W2 upon root 3, and this will come out to be W1 minus W2 is equals to 28.63 K. I have W1 plus W2 equal to 50 K kilowatts, W1 minus W2 equal to 28.63 kilowatts. Okay. Now, I have W1 plus W2 is equals to 50 kilowatts. Okay. Now, if I add these two, W1 and W2, minus W2 plus W2 will cancel. So, I will get, okay, I will write this here, 2W1 is equals to 78.63 kilowatts. Therefore, W1 is equals to 39.315 kilowatts. And W2 is equals to, okay, it is 50 minus 39.315 kilowatts, that is W2 is equal to 10.685 kilowatts. 10.685 kilowatts. So when the power factor is 0.71, W1 reads 39.315 kilowatts, W2 reads 10.685 kilowatts. So observe here, the power factor is above 0.5 and below 1. Therefore, both of the wattmeters are reading positive. Okay, five conditions we have seen. One, power factor is exactly 1, both of the wattmeters will read positive and equal. When power factor is exactly 0, both of the wattmeters will read equal, but one of the wattmeter will read negative. When power factor is exactly 0.5, one of the wattmeter will read 0. If the power factor is between 0 and 0.5, one of the wattmeter will read negative. And if the power factor is between 0.5 and 1, both power wattmeters will read positive. So here power factor is 0.71. Okay. Therefore, both wattmeters are reading positive values. Okay. 39.315 kilowatts and 10.685 kilowatts. Okay. Now case 2. Second case. When power factor is 0.4 lag, okay, that is cos phi is equals to 0.4, therefore phi is equals to, okay, phi is equals to cos inverse of 0.5, sorry, cos inverse of 0.4, that is 66.42 degrees. 66.42 degrees. Okay. Same. I have to take the equation for phi, find W1 minus W2, solve W1 plus W2 and W1 minus W2. Okay. So phi is equals to tan inverse of root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. And this is equal to 66.42. Okay, that is equals to 66.42. Now take tan of 66.42. So tan 66.42 is 2.29. Root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2 is equals to 2.29, or W1 minus W2 is equals to 2.29 by root 3 into W1 plus W2. And this will be equals to W1 minus W2 is equals to 66.14 kilowatts. Okay. Whereas W1 plus W2 is equals to 50 kilowatts. Now again add these two, W2 will cancel, 2W1 is equals to, okay, 116.14 kilowatts therefore W1 is equals to 58.07 kilowatts and W2 is equals to -8.07 kilowatts. Since power factor is less than 0.5, one of the wattmeter is reading negative. So one wattmeter is reading -8.07 kilowatts. So what all we have seen in the theoretical analysis or analytical part, it is getting justified here in the examples. So in case 3 on power factor is 0.5. Okay, cos phi is 0.5, therefore phi is 60 degrees. Phi is 60 degrees. So this will be 60. Therefore tan 60 is 1.732. This will be 1.732. Okay, and W1 minus W2 will be 50 kilowatts. W1 minus W2 is 50 kilowatts. Okay, so 2 W1 is equal to 100 kilowatts. Therefore, W1 is equal to 50 kilowatts. W2 is 0. Okay, so the wattmeter which is reading negative will show 0 when power factor is exactly 0.5. Okay, so this is the solution for second example. So it is evident in this example what all we have seen in the analytical part about the behavior of the wattmeters with respect to the power factor value or the effect of power factor on the wattmeter readings, that is true with respect to the these examples. Okay, so next we will move to example number 3. So example number 3, statement goes like this. If readings of two wattmeters connected to measure the three phase power are 350 watts and 180 watts. Okay. If readings of two wattmeters connected to measure three phase power are 350 watts and 180 watts, the second wattmeter reading is obtained after reversal of current coil. The second wattmeter reading is obtained after reversal of current coil connections. Find the total power consumed and power factor. Okay. So in the second example, power and power factor were given. We were asked to find out what is the wattmeter reading. Now wattmeter readings are given. We have to find out what is the total power consumed and power factor. It is simple. Okay. So there are two wattmeters connected to measure three phase power, where one wattmeter reads 350 watts and second wattmeter reads 180 watts. But the reading of second wattmeter is obtained after reversing the current coil connections. Now when we have to reverse the current coil or potential coil connections is when the wattmeter tries to kick back or tries to show the value below zero. That is when the power factor of the load is between 0 and 0.5. So in that case, what I do, I reverse the current coil connections or potential coil connections, either of the one. Here it is given current coil connection, then that reading I take negative. Therefore the wattmeter reading W2 is, magnitude is 180 degrees, but 180 watts, but I should be taking minus 180 watts because this reading is obtained after reversing the current coil connections. Okay, so therefore W1 is 350 watts, W2 is 180 watts. Okay, therefore total power consumed is, power consumed P is equals to W1 plus W2. It is total power consumed, and this is equals to 350 plus of minus 180. So this is equals to 170 watts. So power consumed is 170 watts. What is power factor? Cos phi. Cos phi, I have expression. Cos phi equal to cos of tan inverse root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. Now substitute the values of W1 and W2. I will get cos phi. So this is equals to cos of tan inverse. Now one of the wattmeter is minus. It means that my power factor should be between 0 and 0.5. So I should get cos phi equal to less than 0.5 and more than 0. Tan inverse of root 3, 350 minus of minus 180. Please note this, 350 minus of minus 180 divided by 350 plus of minus 180. And this will come out to be 0.182. Okay. This will come out to be 0.182. So the power factor is greater than 0 but less than 0.5. Okay. So this is the solution for third example. Okay. Now we'll move to fourth example. Example number 4, the statement of the example is given as, a 3-phase star connected load draws a line current of 28 amperes. A 3-phase star connected load draws a line current of 28 amperes. The load KVA and KW, okay, that is load KVA and kilowatts, are 25 and 22 respectively. If two wattmeters are used to measure the power, find the readings of each wattmeter. Okay. A 3-phase star connected load draws a line current of 28 amperes. The load KVA and KW are 25 and 22 respectively. If two wattmeters are used to measure the 3-phase power, then find the reading of each wattmeter. So example number 4, okay, load KVA is equals to 25, okay, and KW is equals to 22, IL is equals to 28 amperes. Now if two wattmeters are used, then find the readings of each wattmeter. So therefore the total power consumed is W1 plus W2. Power consumed is W1 plus W2. And already we have seen in the analytical part of the wattmeter analysis or wattmeter discussion that wattmeters will always measure the real power. That is the power that is expressed in watts. Watts, kilowatts, megawatts, gigawatts, whatever. But it is in watts. Therefore, the power consumed by the load is kilowatts. Here it is given is 22 kilowatts. Here P equal to W1 plus W2 is equals to 22 kilowatts. Because wattmeter reads kilowatts or watts. Okay. So P is equals to W1 plus W2 is 22 kilowatts. Then what is this? KVA. Now KVA is the total power given to the circuit. Okay, we know that in a power triangle. Now first draw the power triangle. Power triangle per phase, always per phase, okay? Or whatever, power triangle, we just measure. Okay, so this is EI cos phi, EI sin phi and EI. So it is expressed in watts or kilowatts or megawatts. It is expressed in volt ampere reactance or VAR or KVAR or MVAR. It is expressed in volt amperes or kilovolt amperes or megavolt amperes. If the range is more, gigavolt amperes also is possible. Okay. So now I have kilowatt of 22, EI cos phi 22 kilowatts, EI 25 kVA. If I draw the same triangle, I have 22K and I have 25K. Okay. This I don't know. Let it be. Okay. I don't want that. EI sin phi. Right now I don't want it. I need not to worry about that. EI sin phi. Now can I get cos phi from this triangle? I know base, I know hypotenuse. I can get power factor. So what is power factor? Power factor is nothing but the ratio of active power to total or apparent power. Active power or real power, both are same. Okay. Active power divided by total or apparent power. So therefore cos phi is equals to, therefore cos phi is equals to, from this triangle it is 22k divided by 25k. This is equals to 0.88. This is equals to 0.88. Yeah, lagging or leading, there is no information about that. Whether the load is inductive or capacitive, I don't know. Or it may be resistive also. No, if it is resistive, it can be power factor equal to 1. So it is definitely inductive or capacitive. Okay. So therefore, no need to write leading or lagging. Now I know what is cos phi. I know W1 plus W2. Okay. So what is cos phi is equals to cos of tan inverse of root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. Now this is equals to 0.88. Now find the value of W1 minus W2. I have W1 plus W2, solve it. Okay. So I will directly write for this example. This already we have solved 2 times in the previous case. Okay. So W1 minus W2, what I get is, from this data, it is 6.85 kilowatts. Okay. And W1 plus W2, I have 22 kilowatts. So when I add, I get 2 W1 is equals to 28.85 kilowatts. Therefore, W1 is equals to 14.425 kilowatts. And W2 is equals to 7.575 kilowatts. Okay. So this is how we have to solve the 3-phase numericals. So this examples what I have solved in today's class and the previous class include all the types of examples that we can get in three-phase circuits. Okay, you practice the remaining examples, okay, in the same lines. If you get any doubt, you please get back to me and we will see here the three-phase circuits. We will end the three-phase circuits here. In the next class, we will start the next part, single-phase transformers. Okay, thank you.